Hello, hello, dear students. Welcome to your English class. This is Mrs. Jenny Rodriguez, and I'm so happy to share with you. Stay home, stay safe. Just stay home the most you can. But if you really need to go out, wear a face mask and wash your hands. Today we are going to continue with the present perfect tense, but we are going to study the negative sentences. Hoy vamos a continuar con el tiempo presente perfecto, pero vamos a estudiar las oraciones en forma negativa. Review. Let's review briefly some characteristics of the present perfect tense, its structure, and when to use it. Repasemos brevemente algunas características del tiempo presente perfecto, su estructura y cuándo lo usamos. Number one, present perfect structure. Let's study the structure. Vamos a estudiar la estructura. We have subject plus have has plus participle. Sonia has written a book. Sonia ha escrito un libro. Tenemos el sujeto, Sonia. Utilizamos has. El participo es written, complemento a book. When do we use have or when do we use has? ¿Cuándo utilizamos have o cuándo utilizamos has? It depends on the subject. Esto depende del sustantivo. The word have, la palabra have, la utilizamos with the subject I, you, singular or plural, they, and we. Has is used with he, she, or it. Number three, participle, irregular verbs. Remember, the participle is the third form of the verbs. We have the present, the past, and the participle. Let's go over some verbs. Escribir. In the present. To write. Wrote in the past. And written in past participle. Hacer. To do in the present. Did in the past. Done in participle. The verb ver is to see in the present, saw in the past, seen in participle. Ser o estar, the verb to be in the present, am, is, or are. And in the past, was, or where. And participle is being. Conducir. To drive in the present. Drove in the past. Driven in participle. Participle, regular verbs. Now let's recall some regular verbs. Vamos a recordar cuáles son los verbos regulares. Those are the ones that end in ed. Si nos fijamos, son los que terminan en ed en el pasado, al igual que en el tiempo participio. For example, terminar, to finish in the present, finished in the past, and finished in participle. Jugar, to play, played, played. Viajar, to travel, traveled, traveled. Vivir, to live, lived, lived. Trabajar, to work, worked, worked. Number 4. Present perfect in use. Número 4. El presente perfecto en uso. ¿Cuándo lo utilizamos? One main use of the present perfect is. Uno de los usos principales del presente perfecto es. For things that happened in the past, but it is not important when they happened. Para cosas que pasaron en el pasado, pero no es importante cuando estas pasaron. For example, Lucas has been to Canada. Lucas ha estado en Canadá. Lo importante es que Lucas ha estado en Canadá, no cuándo o cuántas veces ha estado en este lugar. Another main use, otro uso importante o principal, for things that have started in the past but have continued in the present. Por cosas que han comenzado en el pasado pero han continuado en el presente. For example, they have lived here since 2012. Ellos han vivido aquí desde el 2012. That means that, esto significa que, ellos comenzaron a vivir en este lugar desde el 2012 y continúan viviendo aquí. Now let's see how to write negative sentences in the present perfect tense. The present perfect negative sentence structure. We have the subject, tenemos el sustantivo, igual el uso del have or has, plus the word not. Más la palabra not. And the participle. Sonia has not written a book. Sonia no ha escrito un libro. As we can see, we have the word not between have or has and the participle. Como podemos notar, tenemos la palabra not entre have or has y el participio. Now we have some examples of negative sentences. They have not been to Paris. If we use the contractions, they haven't been to Paris. Ellos no han estado en París. Podemos usar también la contracción haven't. Mary has not played soccer. With a contraction, Mary hasn't played soccer. Mary no ha jugado fútbol. We have the word yet. Yet is used in negative sentences. It is used if we want to emphasize that something has not been done yet. Usamos yet para enfatizar que algo no se ha hecho aún o todavía. For example, they have not been to Paris yet. Or they haven't been to Paris yet. Ellos no han estado en París aún. Practice time. Don't forget. Practice makes perfect. La práctica hace al maestro. Let's change the affirmative sentences to negative form. They have traveled around the world. Ellos han viajado alrededor del mundo. In negative, they have not traveled around the world. Or they haven't traveled around the world. He has driven a car. Él ha conducido un carro. In negative, he has not driven a car yet. Or he hasn't driven a car yet. Él no ha conducido un carro aún, pero puede hacerlo después. You have seen my dog. Tú has visto mi perro. En su forma negativa sería: you have not seen my dog. Or you haven't seen my dog. Mateo has done his homework. Mateo ha hecho su tarea. In the past form, Mateo has not done his homework. Or Mateo hasn't done his homework. Here we have the last one. María has finished her job. María ha terminado su trabajo. What is the negative form? María has not finished her job yet. Or María hasn't finished her job yet. If you think we have finished, si piensas que hemos terminado, you have hit the nail on the head. Has dado en el clavo. So, have a nice day and goodbye. God bless you.